kama kawa, kama kawaida, tunazidi tukizidi na mie wako mjomba ndani ya sema na mjomba.
Hiyo transition, sasa kutoka from being a car dealer to sasa, becoming a creative, ilikuwa aje?
Sasa hiyo ni story mzuri sana. So, a good friend of mine called Mungai Thiro, he was a general sales manager and I was sales manager.
Yes.
So, alikuwa anatengeneza alikuwa na he was the one in charge of events za CMC.
Ah, okay.
So tulikuwa na golf day and then something tragic happened. Just when we were organizing the golf day, his mother died.
Well,
so he had to go and take care of those things. I mean, he was devastated. It was really painful. So he had to go and take care of those things. Incidentally, just out of the blue,
yes.
he's the father of this singer, anaitwaje? Kagwe. Na kagwe Mungai, sasa ndio mtoto wake.
Ah, okay.
Wewe Mungai. So, by the way, now he also related to Mishoki. Surprise, surprise.
Kini nenda ikiongezeka
tu. Inaweza kanyi Mishoki issue. Anyway, so Mungai had to go and take care of the issues for burying his mom. So the boss said, who's going to, by the way, boss wetu alikuwa mkali, Mr. Martin Foster.
Moto.
Kaburu. Alikuwa dio government ya colonizers.
Wow, so you can imagine. Wakula mchezo wale watu. Watu wa maumavu wale.
Akasem, who's going to be in charge? So he said, I think Moniki can handle it. Are you sure? I said, ah. Patia kijana atajaribu.
Wewe kwa jichocho utacheza kama wewe.
Nikaorganize hiyo kitu. Kuorganize, kulikuwa na entertainment, kulikuwa na you know, drinks, kulikuwa na orodha ya vile watu wanacheza golf, you know, all the different things, all the different facets, nikai organize. That guy wanted to see me every morning. Alikuwa anataka naingia ofisi yake. What is happening? What is happening?
Report,
report kila siku. He sinili sweat. Lakini, when it finished,
yes.
and I put a little touch, because ndikuwa kama lights, I got the two beautiful girls, you know, giving out brochures, nini. When he finished, and now we are displaying the cars, we have to display the cars. It was a lot of work. I've just come to think of it. Because I'm dealing with five divisions.
Wow.
We've got five divisions. We had Mazda, we had CMC, the main one. We had the heavy commercial vehicles. Which other one? There was Suzuki, there was VW, there was Land Rover. All those, I was making sure all of them had their place.
Zote zitaonekana vizuri.
Yeah. They said, who's going to be the MC? I told him, ah, me the MC.
Me niko hapa bana.
Niko hapa.
Lakini niki full package.
Nikajichocha hapo.
Noma sana.
When the day was over, you know, for him, he can't give compliments. How could I pay the compliments? But I came home, he said, it was all right. Mzungu akikwambia it was all right.
Unajua umeweza.
Tumeweza. So, Thiro akarudi ya Mungai akisema, oh, the guy was happy actually. Yeah, he was happy. So, now, nikaanza kutengeneza, to organize my events for CMC.
Yes.
And we had quite a number of them. Including motor show, going to the showground, the concours, the elegance, all those. So, sasa, I started seeing, aya, niko na hii talent ya kuorganize mavitu, you know, kwa MC nini. I mean, professionally, because now, I was doing MC for church, but now, I'm doing it professionally. Okay. So that's when I decided, niendelee na hii kitu. Si nikuwa nataka kuwa Michael Jackson? Si nikuwa nataka showbiz?
Yes.
Nimeshafanya Forever Live, nini, okay.
Mamanejo watu pale, artist.
Now, I can actually make money. Before, I was doing it as a hobby. I'm saying, hey, can I start making money out of this? So the day I decided, let me move. Okay, so I was poached by Marshalls.
Okay.
Nikaenda kwa Marshalls. Marshalls, I stayed 4 months only. Alafu, wakapata, usomaya akaingia, akagongana na Moi. Sasa ukigongana na Moi those days.
Wewe umekuja, story yako imeisha.
4 months, all of us are on the
network. And
we're called the dream team. Tukaambia, Benny home.
Wow. So, nikarudi kwa drawing board.
Sasa,
fine.
Events. Sasa ndio Balozi kanika.
Balozi production sasa. Kali sana.
Hey, Balozi, tulianza na Balozi Africa. Unajua Balozi Africa, the singers, the musicians. We did a nationwide talent search. Hata watu kama Macadam walikuweko. Churchill mwenyewe alikuja kafanya audition. Churchill. Dambuki.
For real?
So many of them. Hey, wa many. Even Alvan who nini msanii
kutoka Nakuru.
Kutoka Nakuru. Mm. He was one of them. Bobby Washira, Mona Ombogo. Wow. Mona Ombogo the script writer.
Yes.
She was one of us. Hey, mazi tulikuwa wengi.
Hey, your group iliweza.
Yeah, iliweza. Hey. And we took it to the next level. We got favor from Standard Group. We had full adverts on and we paid them like Ivy. Wakatupatia spread, we on TV, we on red.
Hey, it was a boom.
Then I was supposed to be doing a US tour.
Yes.
Alafu 9/11 ikafanyika.
Usama na Lani Bella.
Karibu mambo.
Karibu akachoma. Akachoma
hiyo picha kabisa. So even traveling, they were not giving visas, it just became difficult. Ah, wow. Tukawachana na hiyo kitu. So anyway, so because of that, Noah Balozi was born and we started doing events. I remember my first event was for World Vision. Huko nanini, railways.
Ah,
and we had a function, a musical extravaganza.
Yes.
Kukanyesha. Mazee, nafikiri watu watatu ndio walikuja. So then I'm thinking, oh my God, yani events inaweza choma wewe.
Inaweza choma, eh? Pesa imebwagwa lakini sasa ile returns unajua ni zero, negative. Eh.
Ah yeah. Thankfully walikuwa wame ni bankroll yote.
Ah, okay.
So I didn't go to at a loss myself, but I felt so bad. Because we had owned the stage, nini.
Mm.
And I just thought, kumbe, that's cool. So I decided now to get clients who can pay for the event. So
So
from there I did a lot of events.
Yes.
I did Miss Kenya's, Miss Nairobi's.
Wow.
I did for Beersdorf, for East African Industries, now is now Unilever. GlaxoSmithKline.
Yes.
Hey, but that's when I became very good friends with Bikev, the late Bikev.
Ah, yes.
To find out need Lucozid Boost. We did the launch for them at Carnival. Hey, man, that guy had got ideas.
Wow.
Hey man, that man, hats off to him.
Yeah,
that,
we salute him. We salute him.
Great man. Mm. Great. Mm. That guy should have been president. That guy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Angefika president.
That is system yet we.
Angefika. The way he was rallying young people.
Yeah.
Ah, he was incredible.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, he lived his life full
and
we have a good memory of him.
Mungu ilaze ma rohaki mahali
pema peponi. Yeah, thanks Bikev.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that's how I decided to go into events.
Yeah, into events.
Yeah. It became like that.
Don't only watch and enjoy. Click the subscribe button and like our videos. Cheza karibu.
Sasa ukaingia hewani. Ukatuvuruga pale late night show.
How did you know about that?
Sunday breakfast show. Capital FM.
Unafanya homework,
Tuibie siri, uliingiaje kwa radio by the way?
Sasa, things were thick events wise. Things were thick. So, in fact, it's that time, just the same time I was being laid off. Uko nini, Marshalls.
Marshalls.
By the way, being laid off is a real thing.
It is.
You know, before it was unheard of.
Mm.
So when I was laid off, I was thinking, hey, is the world ended? From driving brand new cars from showroom, ndio mimi naingia matatu. Nikarudi matatu, naingia matatu. Thankfully, God gave me nini. He gave me a feeling of, I'm not what I have.
Yes.
I'm me because he loves me. You know?
True.
So that really helped.
Oh.
It really helped. Mm. I mean, I would see people I know in a car passing and I'm walking. And I think to myself, ujifiche
ama nini? Yaani ardhi ifunguke tu uzame ndani.
And he said, achana nayo. So God encouraged me.
Yes.
It was a dark time. But God encouraged me. Then my cousin told me, anyway, but say, yeah, he was at nini? He was at Capital FM. He told me, "Sikuje nini utafute voice test." Just then, Phil Matthews had just left.
Mm-hmm.
Dusty Rhodes had just come.
Mm-hmm.
Neil somebody, I can't remember his full name, but Dusty Rhodes. So they were looking for new guys. That was the time Akina Caroline had moved to Kiss.
Yes.
So there was like a gap. So he told me, "Come and do voice test."
Yes.
This is Jimmy Garthew, eh? So Jimmy tells me, come to voice test. So Nikaenda. They were happy. I'm like,
wow. You sauti imekuwa happy hizo miaka yote.
So I don't, hey, but then, so nikaingia ndani. He sent me off as a trainee. I was understudying Farid Kimani. Then they gave me the late night show and I started doing late night. Then after that I started doing Sunday breakfast show.
Yes.
And for a whole year nilikuwa nafanya kwanza.
Nilikuwa kali sana.
I was the guy doing the shift. Yeah, nini, the night shift to keep tukipita between 1999 to 2000.
Oh, New Year's Eve.
That was crazy. You know, yeah. I was saying that the computer zitazima, sijui, ndege zitaanguka, sijui. It was so much fun. I was in the studio that day. Hey. It was so interesting. Wow. So I did that for a year, about a year. It was, I really enjoyed that time. Because mm-hmm. You just ni kuongea, ni kuongea, unatafuta interesting stories, but we had not reached the level of today. You know, us guys were still very, we were docile compared to what we see today.
Yeah.
We had manners, we were not, hakuna abuse, and I think radio has really gone a notch down. The kind of topics people discuss, you see, morality issues were, you know, no-go zone, you know?
Yes.
And you try to be a gentleman, you try to, you know, be accommodate different opinions. Eh, siku hizi, ukisema kitu, mkina na kugonga
hapo. Pana hewani tu.
This radio has become, instead of uplifting people, it's just been a place for downgrading and tearing people down. And sometimes I wonder, I don't know. If you're consuming that a lot, what kind of person does it make you?
Yeah.
What kind of person, how do you feel? I wonder about that. I wonder what generation we shall reap.
But there's light at the end of the tunnel.
At least the guys, Esther and others yourself are doing clean quality.
Yeah,
I think that's important.
Yeah,
CTA, clean the airwaves.
Yes. Kusafisha kabisa mitandao.
Yeah.
Mwaka jana, engage.
Oh, uliwa.
Yeah.
I was vulnerable. Nilikuwa vulnerable sana hapo.
Ilikuwa shown. Poa sana, because ulifanya pamoja na babako and your son. The execution was so nice.
The execution, I mean, I give that to Don and Agatha of Engage. Their planning is on another level. Eh? Mm-hmm. You have five sessions with them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and you start a story, tell, no, cut that out. Cut that. How is it working? Endelea na hii thread. So they coached us. It was very interesting. And imagine, they tell you, write it out.
Yes.
This was like the third meeting.
Uh-huh.
Write it out. So send it in. So you send in the written thing. Uh-huh. And then you stand there now with the paper. Say, okay.
You want the real use as a B.
I've written it. You know what is surprising?
Yes.
Once you have written something, you can get it from your head. Your memory
you can't forget.
Remembers.
Yes.
See, you don't wrote it.
Yeah.
It remembers.
That's true. That's
I was so shocked.
Wow.
That is something I learned from that experience.
From Engage.
Because I didn't know that my mind can retain details to that level.
Mm.
Yeah. For wow. 9 minutes of content.
Eh?
Yeah? 12
nine
minutes of
flow,
content.
Iko. Kuliko na take 1, take 2, ama you just really flow.
That was not, there's no takes. You're doing it in front of a live audience.
Yes.
Flow.
Wow.
So basically what they do, it's from the Toastmasters program.
Yes.
They now took it to the next level. Uh-huh. Instead of just doing topics, even TED do, now they talk about yourself.
Yes.
Mm. And I thought that was really, really amazing.
They're doing a very good job.
Yeah. Those guys, hats off, man.
Your story is very inspiring.
Thank you.
Actually, I've watched it so many times. Eh? Yeah. And I can't, leo nikienda nyumbani, nikifeel niko down kidogo.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Son of encouragement.
So, pongezi sana.
Praise God, man. Praise God.
Don't only watch and enjoy. Click the subscribe button and like our videos. Cheza karibu.
Uhusiano wako na watoto wako, imekubadilisha aje?
Hey, mazii, inabadilisha maisha mtoto.
Mm.
Hey. Nakumbuka kama jana yani nikishika mtoto wangu wa kwanza Mumbi nikishika aya yani huyu ametoka kutoka mimi huyu
wow
hi ni baba ama bado
mimi ni baba
that feeling
it's a very good feeling you can't even explain
compare that with anything. Hey, ati what?
Hey.
Alafu, mi nikapata na premonition, kama epiphany.
Yes.
Nikajiona, nikimchukua msichana, nikimwoka down the aisle.
Yes.
Kutembeza down the aisle.
Uh-huh.
And that was a very clear message from God.
Yes.
Akuwa anasema, you have her for a short time.
That's true.
Make the most of it.
That's true.
very short time, and then you give her to someone else. Mtoto ni wangu, you just hand off. So that short time, make the most
best out of it.
And I tried to, as my every moment, I tried to maximize it. Because inaisha haraka sana. My daughter now is, she's finished university, she's working.
Yes.
Now, in fact, she has told us, hey, now I'm ready to get married, man.
What? So ile siku inakaribia, ile siku unaona iki, inakaribia.
So now, so are there any good men out there, you know, talk to me. She's a nice girl. So
DM zitajabu.
And brother, I mean, anipatia ruhusa. I said, Dad, if you find a good guy, let me know.
Wow.
I will have she will have the final say.
Yes.
But I said, find a good guy. Introduce me, no problem. So yes, I try to spend as much time with my children.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I made a lot of sacrifices in life.
Wow.
Career-wise, instead of going to a career that would take me away from them.
Yes.
I decided, no. I want them
closer to them.
Closer to home. Uh-huh. In fact, the only reason why she went to boarding school, because sababu alikuwa anacheza sana. Yani he's mastare, yani tulikuwa na niko town, niko city, niko shule majuju, yani. No, do you know who I am? Wait, sana.
Alikuwa diva kiblani.
But it helped because at the end aka straighten akasema well nyinyi wengine msikuje hii path
hapana
muende kupenda boarding school hapo ipenda hata kidogo lakini we used to visit a lot and, you know, we are pretty much apart but mpaka this day anasema ilikuwa traumatic. In fact, when she left she said don't when she finished form 4 Sema, don't give me anything. For 1 year, leave me alone. So she would just wake up, saene nataka, nalala, whatever time. She was for a whole year, free. She went, she did
her.
She was doing fashion design. Mm. She tried her hands on many things, making gifts, nini.
Yes.
She was just having fun.
Yeah.
Then she went to university. Akamaliza, she's done a degree in business administration and HR.
Unajua umesema jambo la muhimu sana. Kupatia mtoto nafasi ya kujifind.
Yeah.
Because unajua kuna wazazi ambao wanasema kama yeye ni daktari anataka mtoto wa kuwa daktari, but kumpatia space ajifind, very important, very important.
Ili msaidia sana baby. Because ukimwangalia she's very stable. Unajua she ana nini. Now my son sasa ndio anaingia hiyo kitu. He's in that field of leave me alone.
Let me find myself.
So that's what is happening right now, but he's doing a lot. He's ameanza biashara yake. Kichakitari kidogo kidogo.
Okay.
And ameingia field yangu anafanyanga scripts na research.
Yes.
Tunafanyanga reality show, yuko anafanya research sana. So he's doing a lot of that research now and then he's a cameraman and he's an editor.
Yes.
So wanapenda hiyo.
He's a very lucky guy. Kwa sababu akona mentor pale nyumbani. Ako sawa. Ako tu sawa.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, Mwaniki, daddy problem. Is changamoto kubwa sana.
Yeah.
Changamoto kubwa sana. Na sijui ni nini tunaweza fanya kama wanaume kuweza kujinasua kwa ile minyororo ya. That challenge.
One of the things kubwa sana. Unajua kuna mtu anatuonesha wanatufunza kuwa father. Nobody shows us.
That's true.
Mm. Nobody there's no school that tells
hakuna blueprint.
Hakuna blueprint. Mm. So many times watu wanajaribu kufanya vile walifanya baba zao wakifanya. And sometimes I say our fathers were not the best example of being of good fatherhood.
Kweli.
So I think we need to look at the fatherhood of God. How God is like a father to us. Hiyo inasaidia sana. I had a very good father. I mean my father figure was amazing. In fact too strong.
Yes.
So the kind of getting alikuwa too strong. too involved. but it taught me about a father's love.
Wow.
And how you can make or break your children.
Yes.
Well, the Bible says children obey your fathers and you know obey your parents then you live long in the land.
Yes.
Then it comes back to the father and says fathers do not exacerbate, do not discourage, do not break down your children.
Kweli.
Kwa sababu hiyo ni shida. Ukiwa na authority kama father, you can break them down with one word.
That's true.
Very useless. That in itself will break down the child. So I think we need to look at that example of God and, yes, and see that God encourages even when we are really naughty. Tumeenda huko side ingine anatukuja kuja anatubembeleza na and I think that I learned that a lot. And I thank God for my wife and nilisaidia kuwa balanced. Wow. Kwa sababu saa zingine nilikuwa nakasirika.
Asiri na kupanda
kabisa ndio. Mimi niliona babangu alikuwa anatuchapa sana. Ile stick ya polisi.
Umejaribu nayo sana.
Tunajua vile na. Kwa hivyo so shoot him na cool down first, then go
relax.
And talk to,
wow, wow.
So even when I used to cane them, I was doing it more relaxed. Mm, with it with anger. Na maanza maliza mtoto. And I think that's one of the things we need to know, that uh-huh, as fathers tuko na responsibility kubwa,
yes,
ya maisha ya watoto wetu.
Uh-huh.
If you do not encourage them, mm, and empower them,
yes,
and give them self-worth,
uh-huh,
and speak life, mm, into them,
mm,
and speak honor, mm, into them,
mm,
and direct them in the way that they should go,
yes,
then who do you think is going to do that?
Mm.
The world is not going to do that. The world, mm, doesn't care about, mm, your children.
Mm.
You, mm, are the one who's supposed to take care of your children.
Sure, sure.
Yeah, it's your responsibility.
Kweli kabisa. Mm.
So, I mean, the other day it was my daughter's, what was it? Hebu nikumbuke.
Don't only watch and enjoy. Click the subscribe button and like our videos. Cheza karibu.
Oh, ilikuwa Valentine's. Nafikiri ni Valentine's.
Uh-huh.
And my daughter akaandika in her Instagram.
Yes.
This is my firstborn, eh? Kaandika. Kulikuwa na picha ya mimi na yeye. Nikimwangalia hivi. Akasema, my first love.
Wow.
Where will I find a man who looks at me like this?
Wow. Wow. Those are very deep words.
You know, she wrote it, me, I didn't know. It's my son who came and told me, hey dad, come and see. Hebu angalia. And I thought, wow. Kumbe, all that we've gone through, she calls me her first love.
Wow.
Imagine that. Imagine that. I think that's a challenge to all men.
Yes.
To be in a position where you influence your children to a level that they can trust you.
Yes. Yes.
That they can come to you, that they can, you know, that they feel empowered by you.
Wow.
Wait, Mazi, that humbled me, Annie. Even to this day, I'm like, oof, okay. Men cry sometimes.
Wow, that's very deep. That's very deep. Kuna post uliweka jana kwa Facebook.
Eh? Gani?
Concert nyumbani.
Oh, hey. Concert nyumbani.
Hey. Tufafanulie tu concert nyumbani ni nini?
Unajua, tumeingia hii very very difficult times, hii kitu ya COVID. Unajua, COVID imevunja imevunja manyumba. Because some guys now they can't live together. It's
that's true.
Difficult.
Eh, kweli.
It's kids are at home.
Yes.
Imefunga shule zimefungwa. Mabiashara zimezoroteka zingine. People having to find new ways of living. Not even living, surviving.
Yes.
Wacha
kusurvive sasa,
So we thought, hey, COVID bana is so negative. Where do we get positive energy from? Tukaangalia hivi kunaona some people are doing exceptional things. They're going out of their way. Wanajitolea, wanaweka bidii.
Kwa
vile you know they go provide food for others.
Yes.
They go kuna shida ya maybe kwa mtaa watoto hawatii vile wana they're supposed to stay indoors, mtu anajaribu ku take care of the kids, make sure they're not spreading kitu. There are others who are giving their staff pay, even and don't even know where the pay is coming from, you know, they're trying to continue at least kuna kakitu. So we thought let's celebrate these people.
Okay.
Let's not even celebrate, let's appreciate them. Because babu, we need to see a positive thing in a very difficult time.
Yes, yes.
So Eugene Bogwa decided, that guy is brilliant, but he creates all our shows. Yes. He's a very, very sharp young man.
Yes.
So, najafika 30 bado.
Najafika 30.
You're wondering how mzee and a 30-year-old are together. That's God's divine thing.
Connection.
So, he said, why don't we... You know, we watched kulikuwa na ma-concerts, watu wanafanya ma-concerts. Lakini ziko kwa YouTube, alafu hata DJ walijaribu, lakini DJ they're getting IP strikes because they're using other people's music kwa shida. So we said, why don't we do a mix of this, eh? Talk about these people and appreciate them, the ones we're talking about, the heroes, the local heroes.
Okay.
And then get some artists to sing songs and dedicate to these guys.
Aye, brilliant idea.
So we talked to a few artists. Some said yes, some said no. They came and we said, we try it. Let's see whether it works.
You do piloting, yes.
Thankfully, we were going to do it out of our pocket. We don't have money. We didn't have money, so we had to do this thing. So KFC, Kenya Film Commission, wakasema, this is write down what we'd like to do. Creating content, promoting local filmmakers. Yeah.
Tuko ndani.
Tusaidiane. So it was really cut budget kabisa. Ndogo hivi. Tusema, let's do. Then we got Eno Solik.
Yes.
And a lady called Kate.
Very nice producer.
And we decided, let's work the magic of these people.
Yes.
And we do something. So. Wow. Beginning of this month, tukaenda nini kwa studio.
Yes.
Bensola kaingia, Heart of the Band wakasema ndio.
Tuko ndani
Sitawa, the poet, Mombi, Masharia the poet, yes. And Jazia, and who else? Oh, Aziad.
Aziad mwenyewe.
Aziad.
Huyo mtu. Huyo ameboka na COVID, deadly sana.
Has given that girl talent.
Yes.
Yani, if you think I'm talented, she's 10 times. Wow. She has it. It's just that she's young. When she catch, wait to see. She will vroom as you come and in. She's on another level. And her attitude, she's got such a good attitude.
Wow.
Imagine attitude inaharibu watu sana.
Sana. Kwanza wasanii.
Unafikiri, nimefika. But she's not like that. She's winning. She wants to learn. She's, you have to be, if you're hungry to learn, you will always grow.
That's true.
But the moment you feel you have arrived,
unaanza kushuka.
You know what it means? It's time to go.
That's true.
Si mwio?
Kweli kabisa.
Si here to learn. If you finish your learning, si wende home.
Wende retire.
Na retire, nasema retire. You have to keep learning. You have to have hunger for learning.
Yes.
Always. Never feel umefika.
Yeah.
Hata mimi sijafika. And I'm older than all of you guys. All your ages put together. But I have to keep learning.
Yeah, every day is a learning experience. Unajifunza.
So anyway, tukaja pamoja and it was directed by Eugene and Nimo Madenge. And absolutely fantastic. Wow. Work. You did an excellent job.
Show me the green light. Tell me you're all right. Joko na dawa.
The story of Africa through the Africans' eyes was the greatest story never told.
There are communities that are going out of their way to actually feed people.
You know, hunger is very, very terrible. We are feeding 1,500 every day.
Wakati hii corona ilitangazwa na kukawekwa roadblock, nikapenda kusave au maofisa wa polisi.
Lazima nijue mtoto wa mwenzangu ni kama wangu. Nikasema nitajaribu vile nitaweza. Ni make sure watoto wamekaa kwa maplot ndani.
Ask my shoe.
Uliza nini?
Uliza kiatu.
Yani wasio kuna mashida hii ghetto sana. Hata msiani hiyo corona imuogopeshi manze. Mimi niko hapa tu kusensitize community. Sitaki corona ingie kibira juu. Tunapenda kibira sana. Hapa ndo home.
I saw the need to help women actually get to hospital, especially at night during the curfew hours.
Every performance you see today of music and poetry is dedicated to that service, selfless service of the people, our local heroes that live among you. And this would have not been possible without the wonderful sponsorship of none other than the Kenya Film Commission.
We hope that sponsors will take it up.
Yes.
To end the label. We just keep appreciating one another and the efforts that we're trying. We want to chase away the COVID blues, and just encourage Kenyans. Yeah. It's not all bad.
All the best, all the best. Kumbuka mwana timu Jomba, tuko naye Mwaniki Magere ndani ya Cheza Kama Edition. Kwa hivyo usicheze mbali, car standby for Sema na Mjomba Show Part 2.
Don't only watch and enjoy. Click the subscribe button and like our videos.
Cheza karibu.